Okie dokie. Well, hi everybody, and back on again, and Tom once more for some Gems of War. Okay, so to start with, there's gonna be a chance that I might be calling in tonight. Well, the last two nights at work have been pretty brutal, so, and I'm don't quite have the gumption for a third night like this. Secondly, this morning it was like 20 below zero. That's the weather we got around my neck of the woods right now. 20 below zero, and I guess tonight there's going to be a wind chill advisory. So I'm guessing 20 below. I probably have to actually look into the weather report. But yeah, if it's something like that, I'm really not in the mood to go into work and with those kind of weather conditions. Especially when this morning I tried starting my car up. You know, and then it started up. Like, it just barely turned over. So, I'm thinking maybe my battery's on its last legs or something. So, I'm figuring discretion might be the better part of valor. But again, well, it'll be a judgment call later on. But I mean, I can't really afford to miss work. But on the other hand, too, I sure as hell don't want to have to deal with this. And then, as much of a first world problem as it might sound, the garage door in my apartment complex doesn't work. Or the garage door opener, I'm sitting here click, 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 click. It does nothing, so I had to, like, get out of my car. I had to, like, grab my spare, or pull my main set of keys out of the car, put my spare car key in there, turn it on, and use my car keys. Unlock the door, walk in, push the garage button, you know, open the door, and then I have to go back in my car, pull, you know, it's not worth it. So, I mean, unless it's my garage door opener, that's the issue. But again, I'm considering just calling in and just saying outright, fuck it. But as far as the session goes, probably just gonna do the usual. Just doing some PvP, doing some map farming. Yeah. Yes, we did, Kataro. And this kind of, one, it was unexpected. The music is even copyrighted, even on Twitch. Part of my stream video was muted, so yeah, I wasn't gonna bother trying to export it. Cause if it's copyrighted on Twitch, it most certainly will be copyrighted on YouTube. So and then, as I kind of said here a minute or two ago, couple of rough nights, and technically it's going to be a third one tonight, but so there's, I might be calling in, I don't know. I can't really afford to miss work, but then again, I don't want to risk things getting worse tonight. You get the idea. So anyway, food. I'm going to have some pinto beans with barbecue sauce and my usual chocolate almond milk. Yeah, and hi, Kataro. And then the music. I played this before. Tales Under the Yoke, the Toad Folk. Basically, bedtime story music. Down some. Well, the cleansing and the creating purples and skulls is nice. Don't care for Granny. Don't care about Granny's souls, though. Yeah, and I played a little bit of this morning. So, I don't know if I'll get to it or not. Yeah, so level 6. Ah, yes, I forgot some. Hold on. Brain farted.
Go again.
Let's re-rack that shit. Another bat. Another Batman, huh? Yeah.
Stick a fork in me, baby. I'm done.
Thank you. Definitely don't need blue. There it is. I'm seeing it. It's gonna have to do more than that. I have nothing. So, it looks like I'm gonna have to go with. Matches. Hey, Dissa. Might be able to still use this group.
What a pity. Sighed a tired toad in a shabby green robe. He was staring at the once beautiful mushroom house.
Almost, but not quite.
By himself a long time ago. But now it was just an old, crooked building with pale moss and thick spider web covering every curve and window. The entrance with a round oaken door almost collapsed, and a part of the cap roof fell off. Last pair of winters were obviously too harsh, even for such a carefully planned architecture. It was one of the first projects that he mastered all by himself after finishing the carving school of the Great Bog. He was then noticed, and after 5 years of honest hard work, he was invited to plan a project of the royal castle.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Together with a few more famous carvers.
I don't know, but I do remember Screw saying that it's supposed to be coming up fairly soon.
What a huge honor it was for him. And as he saw his name, Brog the Builder, woven with a golden thread amongst others on the huge royal carpet decorating the main castle hall, he stood there. Dazed with a clear thought. This is it. This is the biggest creation of my life. However, it was surprisingly painful to see that insignificant old creation in front of him slowly vanishing. It was an ordinary house for a simple toad family, but it was where everything started. Well, muttered Brog the Builder to himself, waking up from his own thoughts. This family needs a new home anyway.
Fuck.
I will do my best.
If this were BBB, I'd have been dead.
Beautiful thing in a simple way I've ever made before.
I guess since I'm here. But yeah, this, I said at the start of the stream, there is going to be a chance that I might be calling in sick tonight. Just, 20 below, right? It's, 20 below right now, and there's a wind chill advisory tonight, so... And, this morning, my car just barely turned over. So, yeah, I don't really want to risk it. Not to mention, it's been pretty brutal the past 2 nights, so I'm not quite in the greatest of conditions right now. I think I might have stated in my Twitch description too, so I might end up cutting the stream short, but. Oh, thank you. Almost a free one right here. Almost. Oh, that sucked. That sucked, so, and, this team wasn't put together, like, with the intention of kicking ass and taking names or anything like that. There was some event some time ago that was, that required nothing but dragons. Maybe, some event that required your whole group to be from Dragon's Claw. I'm thinking that's what it was. And I'm also thinking too, whenever you sometimes hear me say, I'm gonna board blow my way to victory. I think this is the group that inspired that. Because that's what I spent a lot of my time doing on this. I don't see it. Wait, let me, wait, this is red. Wait a minute, whoa. What color is this one? Okay, I don't have any red in that one. I only got two in there, but I could easily change that. Three out of four ain't bad. And I usually say for this kind of group, I don't mind if my opponent gets a turn, as long as I get some matches beforehand, though. Yeah, not this shit. Not this. Still didn't work. And they're all stunned, too, so I've been essentially shut down. Supposed to have won that one. Surge, so I've lost matches because of that. Didn't get that crucial surge. Ding. Looking at a loss. Infinite loop. Well, how about that? I got lucky.
Rustling in the thick swamp bushes got attention for the little toad, playing with his friend in the late summer evening. Hush, what was that? I didn't hear anything, but it could be fish or just a breeze.
Nope.
No,
like I said,
replied the first toad.
I gotta get some matches.
Something bigger than a fish.
So.
And it moves above the water. In that moment, a sharp boat's edge appeared out of the plants.
Didn't help.
An old frowning toad was sitting on that.
I gotta get him.
Made of a dry, oily water.
Retard! What the fuck?
Focused on his own thoughts, he did not smile. Yet the children could say that. He was a friendly creature. Good evening, little folks, said the boat toad and coughed. I hope I
not much of a chance against this one.
Of your peaceful game. I am just passing by to see if the south corner of the swamp already has something to offer. What is it the swamp can offer you? Asked one of the little toads with undisguised interest. The finest berries in all the kingdom, of course.
Gonna get my surge.
Now, have a good evening, little ones. I've got no time to waste. With these words, he made two strong pushes with his beautiful, lightweight panels that disappeared behind the low willow branches. Who was that? Asked the young visitor. That was old Bob, the berry belly.
And it all turned to shit. Oh, got lucky.
He told me stories about him and his craft. He doesn't like company, but as far as I know, every cure potion we've got for winter is made out of these rare berries he finds. Oh, it is getting late. Let's get
still not enough
before everyone starts to worry about us. I want to be a boat toad too when I grow up. Right,
nope.
This toad inspired.
Everyone's gonna get cured. Ding, yep. And it's the hero twos. Oh well. Actually beat it. So I think I went 5-0. No, I'm not done. There's another one. Damn, I got lucky. I was gonna say, yeah, all the entire team is frozen, so they should not be getting any more than one turn. This time around. Yeah, 26K. I wonder what the hell he did. Because he's got the same record I do. But yet he's got a 35K. I only got 26. Got a worse record than I do, but he's got 31. And the only other reason I can think of is they're also buffing the shit out of themselves too. Suck. Let's try it again. Maybe I won't get fucked twice. I'm not as bad. Blues or yellows, so was lagging there for a moment. So we got two guys to start with full mana. Totally forgot Spirit Fox is in their group.
It was a dark winter night, and the wind was howling like a thousand beasts. For 3 days, a hunter had been chasing a peculiar creature, a fairy bug of the great bulk. It was such a rare thing to come across this bug that its shadowed nature started to grow over with dozens of strange stories and myths. Some believed that it was a witch trapped in a body of an insect. The others thought that it would make your deepest dreams come true. The hunter himself heard a lot of unbelievable stories like that, but did not believe in them, to be honest. The only thing he learned from his father is that it was a very rare creature with some half-magical properties, and that its meat could feed a few toad families for at least a month long. So with full dedication, he was chasing the bug over the snow hills, curly dark roots sticking above the frozen ground.
Yeah.
When the hunter grew weird, after hours
say, we need to get an entangle on him.
He decided to make a humble camp with a bonfire beneath an old oak tree.
Almost, but not quite.
Tired bones. He dozed off on a soft bed of moss, and suddenly, a truly fairy creature appeared in front of him, floating behind the flames. I know what you want, hunter, whispered the bug, and you have a choice. You can try to kill me
and further and further down in the rankings,
swamp, to the joy of your folk, or you can make your bow sing the most beautiful song, and if my heart sings to it as well, I will make one dearest dream of yours come true. The hunter kept silence for a while, then stood up, took out his bow, and started playing as if it was a harp. A beautiful melody resonated in the bow's wood.
All right, so let's do this faction assault.
Slowly.
No, wait a minute.
When the song was finished, the bug said,
I could do it, but I ain't going to get much out of it.
You wish.
Fang war?
I wish
to this morning.
Everyone in my swamp, so that no one would starve this long, dark winter. I will do as you wish, hunter, replied the fairy bug.
Okay,
and with
I don't...
A flash of blue light disappeared.
I have no way of knowing the required colors
of shimmering stars,
or the colors that that place represents, so I'm going to have to go to the...
Joyful toads met the hunter that
here.
Night. They couldn't believe their eyes, but each cellar of their mushroom houses was full of food of every sort that could be enough to feed them the whole winter, and even the neighboring swamp east of the croaked forest. The hunter told them his story, and from that time everyone in this swamp and in the whole kingdom afterwards called him Fog. The singing bow.
Thank you. Ain't got it. Fucking long slog.
Winter's coming, little fellow, and every sod is getting mellow. The folks are gathered round the hearth to talk and think about their path. Before we see the light of day, the time is right to hear a tale. One tale or two of winds and fires to soothe adventurous desires. A tale of simple folks and kings. Of ancient sorceries and rings. For every taste I'll find a word about a bud, about a toad. Now listen, bog and dungeon dweller. My name is Croc.
Didn't get my surge.
I'm waiting, friend. This is your turn to choose a tale that keeps us warm.
My surge. So, yeah, it's gonna be a long slog. Oh, there go my greens. Thank you. to help, but unfortunately I have no green gems now. So... Yeah, King Gob's really doing the heavy lifting. Probably not gonna have this on that long. If I have it on for at least a little while. Window, Joe. Not enough. I gotta bail out a whole bunch of windows. I gotta copy paste the team. I'll just go with this. Not gonna have this on very long though. Just enough for a taste. my search. Lose the turn. What's up, Martyr? Yeah. Spell table? Oh, I never heard of that one. Oh, okay. So what do you put the camera like over your table so you can see the cards and stuff, or never heard of it being done that way. Help. This is about an hour-long album right here, so definitely not gonna have it on that long.
It's time to do.
I didn't get my surge. Nope. That probably won't be enough. Nope. water be frozen. I turned the shit quick. Shitty start. So, well, bye bye Frozen, or yeah, Blue and Brown. So, looks like I have fuck all on this board. Here go my greens. Whoops. That's the respawn one. Enough, apparently. That was though. I'll search for Joe. Blues are brown, so yeah, King Gob's been doing all the heavy lifting. Oh, got cheap Dargon right off the bat. So, Yeah, I ain't got it. 45. That's 75%. So it looks like he is stuck at level 1 and I degraded performance. Okay. For some reason, I'm not surprised. Too loud. Please tell me it's the same color requirements. And then I can paste. Back up, Joe. Oh, yeah. So, 30, 55. Watch, I probably won't get it. Oh, got it. Oh. Quality, too. Cost goes up regardless of whether you win or lose. So I'm just gonna call it good there. Just for something. Actually, after this battle, okay, so nope, that's not the one, Joe. Mod. Okay, so, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and break off for about 5-10 minutes or so. Gotta use the bathroom, and, most likely I'll make me something else to eat while I'm up, so. Let me fix the volume. Man, whoops! Window not quite right. Some poppy flippers. So, anyway, I'll be back. chicken breast. And hold on, one more thing. Chicken breast with lemon pepper sauce. Poppy flippers. Pop, 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 pop. Yeah, beat me to it. That's what I was thinking. I just thought of that too. Pop, pop, pop.
Let's see what I've got for you today, right?
Pop. Pop. Pop, 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 pop. Pop, pop, pop. Pop, 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 pop. Pop. Straight down the middle. Oh, hey, screw. Oh, bye-bye multi-ball. Hey, ball save. Well, so much for that. There's a ball save. You can barely see it. Oh! Damn, he still got it. It's got its drawbacks, but yeah. But like I've been telling everybody else, there's a chance that I might be calling in tonight. There's 20 below right now, and there's a wind chill advisory tonight, so I'm guessing it'll be like 50 below, so no. Okay, yeah, I saw that too. I think what I was doing, I think I chose whatever class was, whatever class the class trial is all about is the one I chose. I think it was one of those where I'm always forgetting that you don't have to do it that way. Yeah. The end of that. Okay, so it is next Friday. Yeah, Dissa was asking about that earlier. Last I remember, three of them. Okay.
Mana surge.
Yeah. Which is also one of its drawbacks too. They're very vulnerable to stun. Kind of like the Queen Bee's cleanse. Being able to cleanse debuffs is always nice, but if she gets stunned, there goes that. So, and I might say that too in my video. Something else I noticed about the team too, unlike a lot of other teams, the traits they have are just as, if not more important than the abilities. I know a lot of my other teams, I mean, their traits are just there, you know. Yeah, I was noticing that doing some PvP this morning. That, is his name Obsidious? Is that the one that, there's like a percentage chance that he stuns your entire team? That's who it is. Yeah, that pretty much fucked up my team at the outset. Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, I remember this one. There's probably going to be another one here I'm going to skip here eventually. It's pretty repetitious. This is a Innervation, their Movements album. Yeah, got lucky there. Yeah, I got it. Look, a little lapse in mathematics. Yep. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, I remember this album. I got as far as maybe a third of the way, maybe halfway, and ended up having to call it off because it's repetitious. That's a sucky explosion. Oh, and also, this album here, unlike a lot of others I have, this actually came out in 1999, I want to say. Yeah, 1999, so. 90s ambient techno. Thank you. I thought I already did. Yeah. Oh, I'm guessing you meant the mail. Oh, it is? Oh, okay. I didn't know that. I'm used to these being one day only. You have to do a delve to 100 or something like that, don't you? Yeah, yep. It's about as far as I got. Too much of a good thing there. So, yeah, this one here is, can't even pronounce that. Ilivalon? Drums in the Deepwood? Don Paxton Day, you can do it. I actually kind of did that earlier, like a few days ago. I had, if I can remember the name of it, All Seeing Eye or something like that. The colors are like red and blue. It's the one place that I actually am trying to push as high as I can. Oh shoot, I didn't even think of that, yeah. I think you can, like, do the first room and then go right to the last one. Or, I think you have to do all the rooms that connect to the last room. Okay. Good to know on that one. Yep. Saw that. Thank you. Then I'm probably, after this run here, chances are pretty good I'll probably end up shutting down. Well, now it's gonna happen. Thank you.
continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd imagine if you're trying to get a Delta 500, you'd have to have, like, the most optimal group in order to do that. So, yeah, I can see that being an issue. Yup. Yeah, like it. Yeah, it's like I can see I can see him being a requirement. Okay. Yeah, I keep forgetting which of those two colors had the plus two. Okay, so that's gonna do it for me, everybody. I'm gonna go ahead and call it good. I still have to get going on my blog post. I gotta get that typed up and posted up. And like I said earlier, there is a chance I might be calling in tonight. I don't know. I'll probably get a nap in and see how I'm feeling after that. So, yeah. But otherwise, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that. I should be on again tomorrow, my usual default time being 2:30 p.m., and that is U.S. Central Time. But until then, thanks again for coming by, everybody, and I'll see you all next time.